200 subs. Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh. You guys are awesome. Trying to call her 200, am I right? I had to, I'm sorry. Okay, as promised, I am here to showcase three battles from the recent Wi-Fi battle competition for Pokemon Sword and Shield, the Spikemuth Cup. These battles are awesome, and I'm posting these on my birthday. So what do you know? This is awesome. So, the Spikemuth Cup was a singles competition. A lot more casual this time around, as no Dynamax or Dynamax were allowed in this competition. Just made things a lot more fun, a lot more entertaining. Every match was close to some degree. I had fun. I might have screamed at the TV in pure frustration at times. Other times I was just screaming in joy because of all the hacks that was just happening in every battle that I had. Not all of them, but you know, a lot of them were straight up entertaining. And I'm sure that these battles I'm about to share with you today are going to be just as exciting. So before we dive into the battles, let me show you my lineup. I'm going to make this quick. So my lineup consists of Cinderace holding the Expert Belt, Dragonite with the Weakness Policy with Dragon Dance, a defensive Ferrothorn with the Rocky Helmet, a defensive Quagsire with Leftovers. It's probably there for a Cinderace check, because I knew that Cinderace was going to be very popular. I should also mention that Mimikyu was very popular as well, so I brought one of my own. And this set, well, a lot of people use the Life Orb variant. I use the Lumberry set. And then last but not least, we have Rotom Frost. Alright, now that you guys know what I'm bringing to the table for this competition, we can dive into these battles here. Again, I'll be posting three battles in this video alone, so that there's a little bit of variety. Alright, so the first opponent here had a lot of physical attackers, so starting out with Quagsire seemed like a good idea, and right away I go for Toxic, which, yes, I could have gone for the Scald and burn this Snorlax, but throughout this tournament, I must put this out there. I had so much bad luck with Scald burns. I didn't get a single Scald burn in this tournament. Like, I'm not even kidding. I didn't get a single Scald burn. So I thought going for Toxic would be great. Now you can see just how bulky the Quagsire is, as first the Snorlax went for Earthquake and then Giga Impact. Quagsire can take both of those with ease, and I have Recover to boot. So this Snorlax just doesn't have the right tools to take out this Pokemon. So, and I'm actually considering using this Quagsire in Season 13 of Ranked Battles, which I've been doing this entire month as well. I should probably post a few battles with that. I don't know. You guys let me know if I should do that or not. But yes. He goes for, yeah, another Giga Impact, and again, this didn't do as much as I thought it would do, because it's Giga Impact, right? So Giga Impact would do so much damage, but unfortunately, you know, for him, it's just not going to work. So knowing that he has to recharge for a turn, I'm going to go into my Cinderace as he has to recharge for a turn, and the Toxic is really hampering the Snorlax. I was thinking he would switch, but at the same time, he might stay in. I just go for a High Jump Kick. It's Libero. It's fine. I have an Expert Belt on the Cinderace, so the Pokemon that he wanted to go into might take a lot of damage, and I can always switch up my moves if I have to. So he has his own Cinderace out here. I'm faster than it, apparently. A lot of them are Choice Banded, so I guess it's not a surprise. But for this set, it is an Expert Belt, so I can go for some bounces here. And I was trying to get the Paralyzation. And in 3-on-3, it's really hard to figure out all the three Pokemon that you're going to be bringing. So you can have scenarios like this where all the Pokemon are going to be the same. Like right here, you know, both of us brought a Cinderace. So it's just kind of hard to kind of pick the right moves against these Pokemon, you know? So we're doing the best we can, if you know what I mean. And then you have this Garchomp out here. This Garchomp, I had the answer for... I had this Dragonite, which I have multi-scale on it. So I can let it live any one move, unless it's like Draco Meteor or something. I have a weakness policy to boot. So this boosted Outrage is going to easily wipe out this Garchomp. And yeah, you can see all three of these Pokemon were physicals. It's just having the Pokemon that I brought were just perfect for this battle. But again, you know, it's hard to really pinpoint the exact Pokemon. So, you know, I got lucky there pretty much. But yeah, here we go. This is the second battle out of three. Let's see how we do in this battle. Again, all these battles were close, so I mean, it's not gonna be a sweep. We see a Chandelure as I begin with Rotom Frost. This set is a Scarfed variant, so I'm able to outspeed Chandelure, get out of there safely, and go into Dragonite once again. Trying to figure out what he's going to go for. He goes for Shadow Ball. It's going to break the multi-scale, obviously, but we get a crit, or he gets a critical hit, rather. And I'm like, dang, that did a lot of damage. And fortunately, I'm able to survive this hit. I wasn't sure if I should, or rather, I wasn't sure if I could. Sorry, I'm a little bit tired, but you know, it is what it is. And I go for Outrage here. And he has the Azumarill, and that sucks because he has the priority Aqua Jet, and from that range of HP that I'm at, it's gonna easily wipe out Dragonite. So Dragonite really didn't do anything in this battle, but I do have this Scarfed Rotom Frost, and I thought that would KO, but I survived with 3 HP with the Brick Break there, and then, you know, the Aqua Jet. So this Azumarill is bulky and just really killing my team. And then we have this Mimikyu here, my last Pokemon. I have the priority Shadow Sneak, and I'm surprised I'm faster than it, because I thought, you know, Mimikyu is slow, but apparently in this build, I'm faster, so that's great. Now, I have Shadow Sneak for the Chandelure. At that range, I thought that would KO the Chandelure. Chandelure is not that bulky, per se. But man, that didn't quite cut it. But that's fine, because I have the Disguise. That's the best Pokemon to ever use in these competitions, guys. If you don't know how to use Mimikyu, well, this is a great showing of how to use Mimikyu correctly, because you basically get a substitute from the start, giving you the option to outright attack them or go for Swords Dances. So my opponent's last Pokemon is a Galarweezing, and I knew I lost this battle, even if I went for a couple of Swords Dances. It's not gonna quite cut it, as you'll see the amount of damage that this Shadow Sneak will do to this Pokemon. Like, seriously, that did no damage whatsoever. So unfortunately, I'm going to lose this battle. I had fun with that one, because it was close, it came down to the wire. It's A-okay, you can't win all of them, you know what I'm saying? Alright, here we go. This is the last battle of this video. I hope you guys are enjoying it so far. Let's make sure that this one is just as fun and entertaining. So here we go. My opponent starts off with a Nidoking as I begin with Ferrothorn. I wasn't really happy about this matchup, and I was close to switching out into my own Cinderace as I brought it with me, but I'm like, this is a more specially based Ferrothorn, so maybe I can live a Flamethrower. Fortunately, I'm able to, so I'm going to get up a layer of spikes right there, and then I can go into my Scarf Rotom Frost to revenge kill the Nidoking outright with a Blizzard. We don't miss, thank God, because I have my share of hats, you know, by missing a couple of Blizzards that really mattered. Yeah, that's Pokemon for you. So I go into my own Cinderace, as I was expecting his own Cinderace to go for the Pyro Ball. Man, that did a lot of damage. Just, and I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna go for Sucker Punch. Shout out to that person going online there. Shout out to you, bud. And this Sucker Punch can get the job done. So. two of those Powerballs. I probably should have gone for my own Powerball, just seeing how much that did. But again, I'm not Life Orb, I'm Expert Bulk. Maybe a different damage calculation there. So my last Pokemon is going to be my Rotom Frost. Yeah, this one is pretty fast, as you can tell. And Sucker Punch can get the job done. That's fine. Then I can go for my Thunderbolt and wipe out the Cinderace. And I'm like, that's great, because whatever he's going to bring in, I might revenge kill it. It's Urshifu, thank God. I could KO it with Thunderbolt. Nope, we can't, because he has Sucker Punch. Telling you that Sucker Punches in this metagame is critical. And that was close. That was very close. So I hope you guys enjoyed these battles from the Spikemuth competition. I know these were fast-paced, but that's all I've got because of storage space and whatnot. I would have posted a lot more if I had the amount of space that I have on my recorder, but I have to clean that space up. But anyways, yeah, that's all I've got for you today. Again, if you guys enjoy these battles, that's awesome. Be sure to like and subscribe if you're browsing your way through. You just happen upon this video. And hey, thanks again for the 200 subs. I'm speechless at this point, really. I never thought we could get this far. But we're here, so that's good. Let's keep the train rolling, all right? I hope you guys have a wonderful week. I'll see you guys next week with another battle video. Take care, friends.